about illegal miners living in their midst, but nothing happened until this 16th of January Black. We can have a situation in which foreigners, most of them from French, West African countries, like Gambia, come into our country and be mining our mineral resources illegally. The Chinese are mining gold illegally in Osun State, where there are rich gold deposits in three local governments. The Chinese are there. With the connivance of Nigerians, Chinese are mining gold illegally in Oyo State. The Chinese are mining lithium illegally. Lithium is raw material used in producing batteries. They are mining lithium illegally in Nasarawa State. I've been told that in Oyo State, they have some gemstones. They have beryl, lithium, tantalite, and gold in it, Siwaju local government. These illegal miners rely on improvised explosive devices to blast rocks and all that. And they kept these IEDs in the areas where they live. And look at the damage that they have done. Largely Gambians and Senegalese. Look at the damage that they have done to our people. More than 80 persons injured. As of yesterday, about 5 persons have died. And they are still working, trying to remove the rubble to see if they could rescue some individuals. So, the famous lawyer, Akintola, he lost his hotel. Bola Ige lost his house. The late Bola Ige lost his house. Akeredolu, the former governor, his building was also destroyed. How much longer are we going to permit these illegalities to continue to happen in our country? And given that there's a police station not even far from the area, it makes me sad. They cannot lie. They cannot claim that some of these people had not been reported to them. Neither can the state government claim that it was not aware of illegal mining going on in the state. Now the state government has said, okay, they are sealing up illegal mining sites. This should have been done before now. Look at middle and upper class neighborhoods housing people or scrupulous elements who are hiding IEDs in the area. And look at what they've done. Corruption is at the root of most of the big problems confronting our nation. When people make reports to the police and the police don't take action, the people become victims. The people that they've reported that the police refuse to take action, they become more formidable, they become more powerful. The people will then be scared of them. Whatever they do, the people will just accept because they will be, they are tired of reporting. I have it on good authority that these illegal miners were reported, but no action was taken until this disaster happened and we lost our people, we lost buildings. I also think that emergency response has to be better in our country. Because I saw videos of policemen, police vehicles, you know, taking people away from the scene, when in actual fact, the real emergency responders, health workers, they are supposed to descend on the scene with the ambulances. They are the ones who know how to carry people who are in a fragile state